A mere one-year-old, Duke Leopold III had to rely on the advisors that his father had surrounded himself with, and indeed, that his grandfather had surrounded himself with. Later in 1119, it was spotted that the Kingdom of England had come under significant political strife, and that the heir was now a random adventurer. The advisors to Duke Leopold III decided that it would be an opportune political marriage for one of Duke Leopold's sisters, and so a marriage was chartered between the sister of Duke Leopold III and the random adventurer that was the heir to the Kingdom of England. It was a long shot, but in these dark days for the dynasty, any positive step would have to be taken. In August of the next year, the bad luck for the dynasty of von Babenberg just kept rolling in. Duke Leopold III fell ill. At only 2 years of age, illness was very often a death sentence, and the entire court of Austria held their breath as the young duke fought for his life. By December of the same year, Duke Leopold III had managed to fight off his illness, and he was ready for education. Displaying many natural tendencies towards intrigue, the council thought it best that the young duke be sent off to the Byzantine Empire to be the understudy of the Basileus. A great honor indeed. 9 years later, Basileus Ioannis of the Byzantine Empire passed away, leaving the young duke without an educator, and the future of his education uncertain. 1030 finally brought some good news for the Austrian dynasty, as their gambit in England seems to have paid off. The random adventurer has now taken the throne of England, in a matrilineal marriage to the Duke of Austria's sister. It was now up to the sister and secure the throne of England for the dynasty von Babenberg. Only the marriage of one sibling remained, the Duke's brother, Wenzel. It was decided that it would be best to secure more of the Holy Roman Empire in an alliance with Austria. Wenzel was married off in a strategic marriage to a child of the Duke of Angria. In 1133, Duke Leopold III finally came of age. A master schemer, despite his education, with all the curveballs that he'd been thrown in his childhood, this was surely one of the best outcomes the Duchy of Austria could have possibly hoped for. In 1134, it was finally time for Austria to move on Bavaria. Though not strictly needed under the terms of the Holy Roman Empire, Austria knew that they needed the significant military and economic bonus that owning Bavaria would provide them. But Austria also knew that they could not take on Bavaria in its current state. Following in the footsteps of his great-grandfather Ernst II, Leopold planned to murder the Duke of Bavaria and create chaos, and use the ensuing chaos to invade and conquer Bavaria. Partway through his plans for Bavaria, an emissary from England arrived in the court of Austria. England was engulfed in a civil war for the throne of England. Setting aside his personal gains, and knowing that the dynasty is important above all, the Duke of Austria musters his men, and they march for the shores of England. Cornering the enemy force in Southampton, the following battle was bloody and short, providing the Austrians and their allies with victory, and the Siege of London ensued. With the enemy distracted in the county of Suffolk, the Siege of London went unopposed, and as the walls of London fell, it heralded in the end of the Civil War. In 1142, Austria set its focus back on the Holy Roman Empire, noticing that Angria's royalty was in disarray. It would be a case of simplicity for the Duke of Austria to murder Gert, the heir to the throne of Angria, and then take care of Elof, the eldest daughter, meaning that the children of his brother Wenzel would be set to inherit the Duchy of Angria. A year later, Austria's plans in Angria bear fruit. Duchess Adelheid of Angria takes the throne, married in a traditional marriage to Wenzel, the brother of the Duke of Austria. 1135 is set to be another excellent year for the dynasty von Babenberg. The Duke's sister, the Queen of England, did it. She bore a young son, who's now set to inherit the entirety of the Kingdom of England. Mid-year of 1147, the time had finally come. The war for Bavaria was on. Outmaneuvering the larger and better equipped Bavarian army, the Austrians marched across the border. In records from the Marshal of Austria, it's clear that they would not have won this war were it not for a lucky capture of a hostage during the siege. But the war concluded, and Bavaria was now under the thumb of Austria. September of 1149, the Catholic Pope declared another crusade for the Kingdom of Jerusalem. Once again, Austria decided that they would provide men for this crusade. They would not turn away from their faith now. 1151, the Austrians arrive off the coast of the Holy Land once again. But due to a miscommunication in orders, the Austrians made landfall significantly too early, and the Duke of Austria suddenly went missing from the army. The ensuing battle was a slaughter. It's unknown precisely how much the Austrians lost, but official records indicate that not a single man made it home. Dejected and betrayed by Catholicism, the Duke of Austria decided then and there that he would no longer respond to any requests, official or otherwise, from the papacy. And while Austria would retain good relationship with the papacy, they would no longer take anything they said seriously, for the 5,989 Austrian men who lay dead in the Holy Land. In 1152, Leopold III was offered a position on the Holy Roman Emperor's Council, which he accepted with honor. This once again provided the Duchy of Austria the right to vote in the Holy Roman election, and following in his ancestor Ernst II's footsteps, Duke Leopold III immediately votes for himself. There are several records from July of 1152, written by courtiers in the court of Austria, indicating that the Duke of Austria, Leopold III, may have been a slightly sadistic individual. There are rumors abound of his plans for torture sculptures. These are unconfirmed rumors, however, and all courtiers who made these rumors disappeared shortly afterwards. In 1154, the now spymaster of the Holy Roman Empire, Leopold III, managed to fabricate a hook on the Holy Roman Emperor himself, and in February of 1158, Duke Leopold III of Austria fulfills the dream of his grandfather, and the Archduchy of Austria is born, but remembering well the insults hurled towards Austria from the Hungarians, through their actions rather than their words, Duke Leopold III sets his sights now upon the Kingdom of Hungary. Through the fabrication of a hook, the Archduke of Austria married off his daughter and heir, Agnes, to the second son of the Hungarian queen. Even at the time, many educated individuals in Western Europe would have been able to tell the Queen of Hungary what would happen next. In 1170, the Crown Prince of Hungary tragically died while eating Austrian sweets, conveniently leaving the second son in a matrilineal marriage to the daughter of the Archduke of Austria, the new heir to the Kingdom of Hungary. Having gotten used to a life of luxury as the Archduke of Austria, in 1178, Leopold III passed away from complications to obesity. He's succeeded by one of his two daughters, the 24-year-old Agnes, matrilineally married to the Crown Prince of Hungary. Any child of Agnes's is sure to become one of the most important people in Western Europe. But for now, the Archduke is dead. Long live the Archduchess.